Good evening. I'm Matt, your commentator. In our first reading today, the Great Flood shows the incompatibility between God and sin. Sin is so dangerous to our souls that Jesus calls us to turn from it. And it's so serious that Jesus gives his life for us. As we enter the season of Lent, let us resolve to turn from sin and to be faithful to the gospel of Jesus Christ. The presider at this Mass is Father Daniel Nascimento. Please stand and let us begin. Our opening song is number 130, 40 Days and 40 Nights.
Shall angels shine, such as a few faithful leave. We gather in prayer in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. As the song reminds us, we're entering now into this 40 days and 40 nights. In the season of Lent, we look at ourselves, we look at what we've been, and we look at what we strive to become. So we begin acknowledging our faults, our failures, and we ask the good Lord in his generous heart to help us grow to be our better selves. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, through the yearly observances of Holy Lent, that we may grow in understanding of the riches hidden in Christ, and by worthy conduct pursue their effects. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God said to Noah and to his sons with him, "See, I am now establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that was with you, all the birds and the various tame and wild animals that were with you and came out of the ark. I will establish my covenant with you, that never again shall any bodily creatures be destroyed by the waters of a flood. There shall not be another flood to devastate the earth," God added. "This is the sign that I am giving for all ages to come, of the covenant between me and you, and every living creature with you. I set my bow in the clouds and to serve as a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth and the bow appears in the clouds, I will recall the covenant I have made between me and you and all living beings, so that the waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all mortal beings." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your ways, O Lord, make known to me. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are God, my Savior. Remember that your compassion, O Lord, and your love are from of old. In your kindness, remember me, because of your goodness, O Lord. Good and upright is the Lord. Thus he shows sinners the way. He guides the humble to justice, and he teaches the humble his way.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, Christ suffered for sins once, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might lead you to God. Put to death in the flesh, he was brought to life in the spirit. In it he also went to preach to the spirits in prison, who had once been disobedient, while God patiently waited in the days of Noah, during the building of the ark, in which a few persons, eight in all, were saved through water. This prefigured baptism, which saves you now. It is not a removal of dirt from the body, but an appeal to God for a clear conscience, through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at the right hand of God, with angels, authorities, and powers subject to him. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
King of endless glory. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The Spirit drove Jesus out into the desert, and he remained in the desert for 40 days, tempted by Satan. He was among wild beasts, and the angels ministered to him. After John had been arrested, Jesus came to Galilee, proclaiming the gospel of God. This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. The Gospel of the Lord. Dr. Wayne Dyer, he wrote a book entitled, A Promise is a Promise. In it, he tells a true story about a mother's care for her comatose daughter for over 28 years. She would feed her every 2 hours around the clock. She would turn her so she doesn't get bed sores. And then every 4 hours, she would give her insulin. In addition to that, she raises the money to pay for all the expenses. And then every night, she sleeps in a chair next to her daughter's side. She does this because 28 years ago, when her daughter was 16 years old, as she was slipping into a diabetic coma, her daughter asked, "Mom, will you leave me?" Her mother responded, "I will never leave you. I promise, and a promise is a promise." So during the past 28 years, her daughter has moved through the different stages of coma, from not responding at all to reacting to stimuli in the room. But the most amazing part of this story concerns the effects that the daughter has those who visit her. Some claim to have experienced miraculous healing, and everyone feels the unconditional love that she radiates from her immobile body. I think we're all inspired by someone who is able to make a promise against difficult odds, because we all know how difficult keeping a promise can be. Whereas some vows require only one person to remain resolute and faithful, like sister and I, we make our promise to God. But in marriage, it requires both parties to work together. And as determined as one spouse is to making the marriage work, if the other partner is unwilling to work together, a marriage cannot survive. All the more reason when we see people keeping their promises against difficult odds, like this mother, we're inspired. They give us hope that maybe God will keep his promises with us too, even when we're unable to keep our end of the bargain. As you may recall, when God In the Old Testament, when God freed the Israelites from slavery, God said to the Israelites, "I will be your God, and you will be my people if you keep my commandments." But time and time again, humanity has broken that promise. They were not able to keep the commandment. In today's first reading, the story of the flood, in essence, is teaching us about the incompatibility of God and sin. Sin is the absence of love. Sin destroys and harms relationships and even throws our world out of balance. Yet what the story of the flood teaches is that God desires to save the good. So even if there's just a little bit of good in us, God will attempt to save us. So that's why God saved Noah and his family. And then from today's second reading, we heard St. Paul teaching us that the flood prefigures baptism. It points the way towards baptism, whereas the flood washed away all that was sinful. So it also, in baptism, it washes away our sins. St. Paul interestingly described baptism. It's not washing away the dirt in our bodies, but it's to create a clear conscience in us. While God desires to save the good in us, yet God won't violate our freedom. God won't force us to conversion. Hence, Lent, it's an invitation, right? God calls us to repent, but it's an invitation. It's up to us to respond. Now, for 2,000 years of ancient wisdom, the church invites us during Lent to take the three traditional practices, which are prayer, almsgiving, and fasting. So in prayer, we are encouraged to make time, carve time out of our busy lives, to be in this relationship with God. So your presence here, when you at night, when you stop and make time for prayer. So it's to strengthen that, deepen that relationship that we have with God. And in almsgiving, we are then taught to think of others instead of simply ourselves. Think about those who are in need, whether it's the poor, but it can also be an elderly relative that can use a little bit of attention. So almsgiving, we practice giving to others instead of always taking for ourselves. And the same with fasting, right? We're very good about taking care of our own self, our own personal needs. In fasting, we're disciplining the body we're practicing self-denial. So we're building the spiritual muscle to help us do good. The mother that I shared with you earlier, who promised her daughter that she would never leave her side, shows us how marvelous a promise can be. She gives us a glimpse and helps us appreciate the promise that God has made with us. God will always be by our side, even when we sin, even when we turn our backs to God. God will always reach out to us. Whereas a rainbow is a reminder for God to keep his covenant with us, the cross is our reminder that God kept his covenant even when we were unfaithful. And instead of wiping away sinners by a flood again, God has offered his only son to die for our sins. So the blood of Jesus truly washes away our sins. God has kept his promise. So during Lent, let us examine our own promises to God. Let us renew our relationship with him by entering into prayer, making time for prayer. Let us strive to be faithful disciples, even when we have to go against the currents of our culture. And let us imitate Jesus, our Lord and brother, that we may become truly children of God. Amen. Let us renew our profession of faith in this God who will never leave our side. Let us use the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Heavenly Fathers, we turn again to you in whom we place full trust. We bring you our present needs and these petitions.
For the Church, that each of her members grow closer to Christ and deepen their faith in him this Lenten season, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the adults preparing for baptism this Easter, that they find joy and renewal as members of Christ's body, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our state officials, that they work together to provide solutions for the lack of affordable housing for people at all income levels, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those living on our streets, that they obtain safe and comfortable shelter and receive help for any addictions or mental issues they may be experiencing, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are ill, especially Earl Ingebretson and Joe Laguda, that they find comfort, strength, and healing, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Jimmy Jimenez, Bernie Barone, Joan Benjamin, and Christina Ann Quinn, as well as those who mourn for them, that all find peace with God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
This Mass is being offered for the intentions of John M. Sinan. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, as we enter this Lenten season of penance and self-sacrifice, hear our prayers and grant them through Christ our Lord.
The song for the preparation of the gifts is number 663, Hosea, 663.
Fear. Pray then, my sisters and brothers, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Give us the right dispositions, O Lord, we pray, to make these offerings, for with them we celebrate the beginning of this venerable and sacred time. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. By abstaining 40 long days from earthly food, he consecrated through his fast the pattern of our Lenten observance. And by overturning all the snares of the ancient serpent, taught us to cast out the leaven of malice, so that celebrating worthily the Paschal mystery, we might pass over at last to the eternal Paschal feast. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praises without end, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and from the world's beginning are ceaselessly at work so that the human race may become holy, just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray upon your people's offerings and pour out on them the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too are your sons and daughters. Indeed, though we once were lost and could not approach you, you loved us with the greatest love. For your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of the cross. But before his arms were outstretched between heaven and earth to become the lasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. As he ate with them, he took bread and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, and once more giving you thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our surest peace, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead, and looking forward to his blessed coming, we offer you, who are faithful and merciful God, this sacrificial victim who reconciles to you the human race. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, and those you unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, as they partake of this one bread and one chalice, they may be gathered into one body in Christ, who heals every division. Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart together with Francis, our Pope, and Salvatore, our Bishop. Help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom until the hour when we stand before you, saints among the saints in the halls of heaven, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed apostles and all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters whom we humbly commend to your mercy. Then freed at last from the wound of corruption and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives for all eternity. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. With one heart and one faith together we pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer to each other a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
The communion song is number 441, On Eagle's Wings, number 441.
Let us pray. Renewed now with heavenly bread, by which faith is nourished, hope increased, and charity strengthened, we pray, O Lord, that we may learn to hunger for Christ, the true and living bread, and strive to live by every word which proceeds from your mouth. Through Christ our Lord. We have some announcements. You may be seated.
The second collection this Sunday is for the church's property and liability insurance. Thank you for helping us with this cost, exceeding $133,000 a year. Ushers, you may take up the collection. During Lent, we encourage you to be part of a small group to nurture your faith and to be part of a community. There's something on every weeknight. Mondays at 7 p.m. in the rectory, exploring angels in the Bible and in the world. Tuesdays at 7 p.m. via Zoom, Christian meditation. Wednesdays at 3 p.m. in the Covenant Garden, caring for our Mother Earth. Wednesdays at 7 p.m. in the Rectory, Faith Sharing Book Club. Thursdays at 6 p.m. in the Rectory, Lent and Easter Choir Practice. Fridays at 7 p.m., Stations of the Cross in the church with soup supper at 6 p.m. in the vestibule. If you are not able to attend the book club on Wednesday nights, we invite you to do some spiritual reading on your own. We have two books for you available at our entrances. Beautiful Eucharist is a collection of life-changing reflections about Jesus in the Eucharist. And Fit for Heaven is also a collection of talks from the best athletes and coaches about sports, faith, leadership, family, and heaven. We encourage you to nurture your mind and feed your soul this Lent.
Okay. Thanks, Matthew. Thank you also to our musicians, our servers, our lectors, Eucharistic minister, ushers. So thank you all for your ministry that made it wonderful and successful. Yeah, so there are two books available. Actually, I think there's a third book out there somewhere, also on the deep topic of Eucharist. So this is the year of the Eucharist, so we encourage you to do some spiritual reading on your own. And if you'd like to do this as a group on Wednesday nights, as you heard. And in the vestibule, there's a sign-up table so we can prepare for you so we know that you're coming and we can also remind you. Okay? Please stand. And so may the Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our lives.
Our closing song is number 642, We Belong to You, number 642.